Welcome to the rooftop garden of the Kendeda Building for Innovative Sustainable Design in Atlanta, Georgia. One of the requirements of the Living Building Challenge is to have an urban agriculture component. It's not that we want to get the site self-sufficient when it comes to food, but rather we want to make sure that people understand and have a relationship with food. So the way we satisfy the urban agriculture requirement is by having bees. Yes, we have bees on our rooftop that produce honey that counts towards the requirement. We've got blueberry bushes that count towards the requirement. But one of the most fun things that we do is we have seasonal planting of fruits and vegetables. Today, we are planting for the fall and winter harvest, and I'm going to turn it over to my colleague, Steve Place, who's going to tell us what we're planting, why we're planting it, and what the harvest schedule is going to be.
So hi, today we're planting the winter garden here at Kendeda, and we are planting leeks and mustard, radishes, rhubarb, kale, Brussels sprouts, onions, and a few other winter vegetables. We are working with the students from Students for Sustainability. They are excellent gardeners. We're thrilled to have them here, and they're helping us with our potager.
So what we're doing here is we're marking out where we're going to be planting everything with a material called bone meal. And it works well because it creates contrast with the soil. But on top of that, it's a plant food, so it helps everything once it starts growing.
So today we're planting a potager, which is a little bit more elaborate garden. It's based on a formal layout. We've got four axes and a center of rhubarb. The gardeners have picked out what they are planting in terms of the axes, and the center points are the taller plants. We're doing Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, and again, the rhubarb in the center, which will be a very nice centerpiece.
So SOS is Students Organizing for Sustainability, and we work to promote sustainable practices on campus, and we also run the community garden located by the Instructional Center. And we're really excited to partner with the Kendeda Rooftop Garden to have a new place to expand gardening on campus.
The most important thing about the winter garden is knowing what the winter plants are. So you're going to want leafy legumes, kale, lettuce, radishes, that kind of thing. Something that is going to overwinter well. And so you can either go to your extension service and find out from them the planting list, or do some, check your garden resource books. But the idea really is to work with the seasons. And since we're turning this garden over for intensive gardening, we want to be working seasonally, working with the plants that we know are going to do well, and provide a winter crop so that once this winter crop finishes, we can go ahead and get our summer and our spring and then summer crops in as well.